Yeah, good morning everyone. This is part 16 of ASP.NET. Today we'll discuss about master pages in ASP.NET. In the last video, we discussed about how to work with drop-down list control and examples of drop-down list control we have seen. So master pages means if you want to maintain some part of the web page, mostly with the single master page concept, you can develop the total website in ASP.NET. In HTML, we discussed about frame tags. Similar like frame tags, here we have master pages. It is used to maintain some part of the web page constant throughout your website. Let us assume here you see, this is your web page, and here I divided my web page into four parts. First one is A part. Here this is your A part, this is your B part, this is your C part, this is your D part. I divided my total web page into four parts. Okay, now I want to display the photo in the A part. I want to display the image in A part. And I want to display the hyperlinks in B part, something like home. Here I will try to take about us. Here I will try to take contact us. Is it clear? Here I will try to take some login. Is it clear? I want to display some image hyperlinks in the B part. And I want to display some copyrights in the C part. Generally, when you develop any website, website is nothing but a collection of web pages. Website is nothing but a collection of web pages. Is it clear? It consists of multiple web pages. So repeatedly at the time of developing any website, the common design, that we want to repeatedly the same design will be displayed in multiple web pages. This is your web page now. So here I want to display the image in A part, hyperlinks in B part. Now here if you observe clearly, this ABD is fixed throughout your website. ABD is fixed. ABD is fixed throughout your website. Only C part will vary from one page to another page. So you cannot directly execute master page. Is it clear? You have to create a separate page. Common code belongs to your entire project. You have to create in master page. Is it clear? So your common code, for example, here I will try to create one master page called demo.master. The extension of master page is .master. And you create the separate HTML ASPX pages, home.aspx. Similarly, about us.aspx, similarly, contact us.aspx, something like that. Now, create a master page, attach the master page to any of the individual ASPX pages. That is the point what we have to do now. So, now here I want to create what? I will open my Visual Studio Editor and I will try to create a new project. Let us say. Okay, this is just navigation only, no coding for this. Select empty web forms, click on OK. Okay, now let us see here. Here you can go to your solution explorer. Common design. Okay, now here you can right click on the project, add new item. Right click on the project, here add new item. Select. Here you can see web, and here you can select web forms master page. Here you can select web forms master page. The extension of master page is .master. Here you can give the name as demo.master. Click on add button. The extension of master page is .master. Here you can see demo.master. Go to the design. Here you can see one pink color rectangle box will come. That is called as content placeholder. Is it clear? So just you can see right click on the content placeholder. What to do? Cut the content placeholder. Okay, now here you can go to your table, insert a table, number of rows to columns to, click on OK. Actually, if you want, you can keep something like this. Go to table, insert a table, number of rows 4, columns 1, click on OK. Now 4 rows will come, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now I want to paste the content placeholder in third part. In third part, you can paste the content placeholder. So this is A, this is B, this is D. Okay, na? So here what to do? Go to your toolbox. And now I'm designing the master page. Extension of master page is .master. The common code related to my total website I'll keep in the master page. So here go to your toolbox. There you can drag and drop one image control. In your toolbox you can see image, drag and drop image control from your toolbox. And here you can drag and drop some menu control. Here you can see Here you can see navigation. Under that you can see some menu. Drag and drop menu control from toolbox. Okay, now this is A part, this is B part. Don't do any design in content placeholder, leave it empty. And in D part, here I will try to write something like copyrights. I'll write copyrights some 2020, something like that. Okay, now so here if you want to display any image in A part, go to your solution explorer, right click on the project, add new folder, rename the folder as images. Just a navigation, just watching the video, you can keep the video and pause and you can complete this task. Right click on images, add existing item. There you can select your desktop, and there you can select the folder, any image you can select. I already have a lot of images. I will try to select one image here. Did you understood? Try to select some image. Any image you can select. Are you following? From your desktop. Here something like I will try to select some image. And here I will try to right click on the image. Go to properties. Here you have one property called image URL. Select the image URL. And here select images folder, select the logo youtube.png, click on OK. Now the image will be automatically displayed. Did you understand? So you just try to adjust the image. This is my image, I will adjust here. Okay, na? And similarly right click on the menu control, go to properties, and here you can see there is one property called orientation. Orientation means it will display the hyperlinks in vertical, orientation I'll give as horizontal. So it will display the menu in horizontal manner. Here I'll try to give bold, here I'll try to give some XLarge. Are you following? And here if you want to select auto format, change the format. Colorful. Click on OK. Are you following everyone? This is your copyrights. So this is A part, B part and what? C part. A part I displayed one image. B part I displayed some menu control, D part I displayed some copyrights. Select the menu control, ellipse button, edit menu items. Here you can add the items 1, 2, 3, 4, something like that. Select the root element, the text I'll try to give as home. Second element, the text I'll try to give as about us, something like this. Select the third element, the text I'll try to give as contact us. Is it clear? Here I'll try to give contact us. Select the fourth element, the text I'll give as something like login. Is it clear? This is my design actual. Okay, na? The common design belongs to my entire project I kept in master page. Okay, you cannot directly execute master page. You have to attach the master page to any of the other ASPX pages. Now I'll try to create the ASPX page. Go to project, add new item. We are developing a simple website by using ASP.NET master pages. Now here you can select web forms with master page, web form with master page. Here you have to select, and here you can give the name. Are you following? The name I will try to give as home.aspx. Click on add button. Now it will ask you, please select the master page, which master page you want to add. This master page. Click on OK. Now my page is ready. Home.aspx page is ready. And the design is also fixed. ABD is fixed only. Now here, whatever the design you want to do in home page, we have to, okay, now do the design inside the content placeholder. But actually here one point is that the similar topic is there in Angular also, that is single page application. Though ASP.NET is beautiful, the main problem with ASP.NET is burden on server. That is the reason Angular is also becoming very popular. That is common for everyone. Okay, now similarly, go to project, add new item, select web form with master page. The name I will try to give as about us. About us.aspx. Click on OK. Okay, now here I will try to give something like go to design. And there, here I will try to print something like welcome to about us space. Welcome to about us space. Is it clear? I want to display the data. Whatever the unique design you want to do, you have to do inside the content placeholder. Welcome to About Us page. Similarly, go to the project, add new item, select web form with master page. The name I will try to give as contactus.asp, something like this. Contactus.asp. Okay, okay. Go to design. Similarly, here you can write something like welcome to contactus page. Welcome to contactus page. Something like this you can give. This is your design. And here go to your project, add new item, select web form with master page. The name I will try to give as login.aspx. Click on add button, OK button. Go to design. Here you can see, go to your toolbox, drag and drop login control from toolbox. Here you can see something like this. Drag and drop login control, that is a ready made control. Here you can select something like auto format. Here I will try to give colorful. Click on OK. And here I will try to give bold. Here I will try to give double X large. So my pages, all pages are ready. Now go to your, you cannot execute master page, you have to execute any of the other pages. First go to master page, select the menu control, right click, go to properties. There you can see items property is there, items. Just select the items and here you can select home, navigate URL. Here I'll try to give something like home.aspx. About us, navigate URL. You can give about us.aspx. Contact us, navigate URL. You can give contact us.aspx. Login, navigate URL. Here you can give login.aspx. Click on OK. And whenever user clicks on home, it has to go to home page. Similarly, about us page. Now, if multiple web pages are existing in the same website, you cannot execute the master page, execute any of the aspx pages. So first of all, right click on home.aspx, set as start page. By default, you want to execute this page. Press F5, check the output. See, this is your website. Here you can see about us page, contact us page, login. Whenever you use this login control, you'll get some unobtrusive validation mode error, some JavaScript jQuery error will come. So in order to overcome that error, go to web.config file. Here you can see this line, HTTP runtime target framework, delete this code. And again, go to home.aspx. Again, you try to run this one, build the solution, press F5. Okay, now, here you can see, home, about us, contact us. About us, contact us, login. Like this, you can design the master page. But the problem is multi-page application. The page will refresh every time. Master page means multi-page application only. Similar topic in ASP dot in MVC, you have layouts. But nowadays it is very popular is single page application. That anyway we'll discuss in Angular. For more videos, try to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day.